Hello and welcome. This is Deepak Mishra and I welcome you all to Deminutes International. In this video, I am going to take questions that have been asked on my YouTube channel and I'll try to clarify some points and some discrepancies, some information that has not been clear so far. First question I will take is from Zaka Rahman. She writes that to clear her concept or his concept, I don't understand, like the name is a masculine or feminine name. But the question is, if once you apply with your documents to the for termine for FSP, the medical council takes 4 to 6 months time to verify and to give you FSP termine. And is this called a deficit Bescheid? See, I'll tell you once again, to clarify, what is deficit Bescheid? Deficit Bescheid is when you send your documents along with all the requisite, the language, along with the hospitation letter or the job letter or your communication with the hospitals, the denial, the refusals, all these requirements that are there in the checklist. When you send these things to the appropriate authority, the government authority, not necessarily the medical council, but in some states it's called Approbationsbehörde, some states it's called, for example, in Niedersachsen it is called Niedersachsische Zweckverband zum Approbationserteilung, that is NITSA. In Berlin it is Lage SO. So different states have different names for this kind of authority. You have to send your documents there. What they will do is they will go through the documents, everything is fulfilled, okay. Now they will send it to your home country for verification. Once these documents are, this will take now 4 to 5 months. Once these documents are verified, then they will send you, the documents are verified and they will also send you deficit Bescheid. Okay. Deficit Bescheid is, your question is very valid. Now I realize what you are trying to ask here. See, deficit Bescheid, it was not there last, 2 years back. It came out, the requirement for deficit Bescheid came only 1 year back or something like that. At what point they should issue a deficit Bescheid? That is not clear in many states. Some states give you deficit Bescheid after the verification. Some states give you midway, like they send you documents of verification, but if you have fulfilled those requirements that they have asked and some points are missing, then they'll issue a deficit Bescheid in 2-3 months time these things we received and these things are missing. Things that we have received, we have sent for further verification, and these things which are missing, you have to send this to us. So this kind of this is deficit Bescheid. After the documents are verified, you will get a termine for appointment for FSP exam. And this is also different in different states. Some states in West Germany, they nowadays do not wait so long. You apply to them, they'll go through the documents. They have already thought that, okay, the process of Gutachten and everything is now, like, we do not want to give you the opportunity to go to the assessment program. You have to directly give the exam. So the first Eingangling, 2 months from application, you will get a letter that, see, you have sent your documents, well and good. You're interested in to work in our state, well and good. We have decided that your documents, your education is not equivalent to ours. And if you want to continue, if you're still interested to work in Germany, in our state, you will have to pass this exam. So, and then if you reply to that, okay, fine, I will take it. Then within few weeks, they will give you termine for Fachsprachprüfung. Okay, so this is a new thing. This has also happened that they do not wait now 4-5 months. Depends on state to state. In West Germany, the states like in the places like Northern and Westphalen, these things happen more often because they want to speed up the process. So speed up the process as in the candidate does not have to wait very long. In 3-4 months time, they get termine for Fachsprachprüfung. They come, they fail, they have termine in 3 months again. Then they take the exam again, they fail. So the Umsatz, the rolling, and with this rolling, they also get fees every time you don't pass the exam, and the exam levels are quite high. So in one way, if you consider speed, the states in now on the western part have more speed, they work faster. So in that case, if you apply for visa, if you want a deficit Bescheid, if you want Eingang Bestätigung, the states in West Germany will be more favorable. There you will get things faster. Once it comes to taking the exam and passing the exam, then that will be not so much favorable. That is why, like, one has to balance that what will we do. So from your question, The FSP termin you will get once the documents are verified in most of the states. But in states like Northern Westphalen, you might also get the termin without verification in 3 months' time. So with this, I think I have cleared some part of your question. To exact give you exact answer, there is no uniform answer because no the states do not work in that uniformity. Different states work differently. So unfortunately, that is the case. Next question is from Kanishka Gupta. She writes, I thought the exam was conducted twice a year, April, June and October, December. Kanishka, why did you, please write in the comment, I would like to know, why did this thought come to you that this this was conducted twice a year? So please write a source of your exam, a source of your information on the comment. So that I also know that why did you think, did you just imagine it because we have in our school in first standard to 10th standard, 12th standard, two times exams, is that what you thought or I mean how? There has been no change in the pattern, it was always like this. Okay, so next question is from Rahul and the same question Priyanka also writes about, they want to know about dentists, the process for dentists. See, I have made few videos in the past regarding the process for dentists, which is similar to that of medical doctors. I have also given you list of required documents, the checklist and everything on this very channel. You go in the previous videos and you find out, please find out. See, if you take my opinion on this, I would not recommend foreign dentists to come and try for Germany, because for foreign dentists, I find it's basically a waste of time and money. So you think very carefully for people who are, suppose if there is a dentist whose husband or wife works in Germany as an engineer or something like that, and person is as it is going to come to Germany and going to stay in Germany for a couple of years at least, then it makes sense that okay, you are going to as it is come to Germany and being a dentist instead of sitting like a housewife in Germany, why don't you put your documents in order and send it to the council and let's start the process. For you, it is sensible that okay, you do that. But people who are not as it is going to come to Germany, they will come specifically for this purpose. They will spend a lot of money for this purpose. They will apply for visa for this purpose. They will live in Germany. They are ready to bear the living expenses. I would say it's not worth it because very few dentists have actually gotten it. And that too after long wait, and that too they were in the category which I have mentioned, that they were spouses of people who are already living in Germany or are like coming for engineers, other doctors, like medical doctors whose wives were dentists. So they came here and with the course of time they got everything in order and then they got the license in Germany as well. So they started working. That is, but in your case, if you are a practicing dentist or a dental student and have no connections whatsoever with Germany and just want to do your post-graduation or are looking for a better lifestyle, better work conditions and all, and you think about moving to Germany for dentist, I'm sorry to say, but this is not the way. You will waste lots of time and you will waste lots of money in this process because it is not an inexpensive process. So my suggestion would be to drop the plan about Germany. I'm not trying to demotivate. I'm trying to give you a very blunt and clear picture because the jobs are not there for doctors. There's no shortage of doctors in Germany. See, you have to understand, everybody has to understand that why does any country take foreign professionals in any field whatsoever? Why do they take that? Because there is shortage. They will first prefer a German, they first prefer people from their own nationality who have their passports. That is true for US as well and any other country, for UK as well, so Australia as well. So everybody, every country, even in India, if you have an Indian and you have somebody from some other country, from Africa or some other Southeast Asia, they will not take them, they will take Indians only. So in these countries they take foreigners because there is shortage. There are not enough locals, like not enough German doctors who could take the jobs. That is why there is shortage and that is why they are ready to take foreigners. That is the same case with US and UK. And then in that case, to find a job as a dentist, you need to have shortage and there is no shortage. So this I have explained several times in my previous videos. Please go through them and you will get a better picture. For dentists, Germany is not recommended. Okay. The next question is from Viana. She writes, can we apply job as an assistant arts before this exam? The exam she was talking about is Fachsprachprüfung. Yes, definitely, Viana, you can definitely apply to jobs before Fachsprachprüfung. I mean, you have to apply to a job to get, an interview or a hospitations tag for observership, and with those documents you can apply to the medical council, and when I say medical council, to the approbations authority. So you can definitely apply for assistant arts position before this Fachsprachprüfung exam. Next comment is from Khan Abdul Alam Khan. He writes, hi, thanks for posting this valuable information. Can you please share the link of Ambo's website, which you guys know? Okay, all right. I will just post the link to the Ambo's website that you can also find. Mr. Khan, you will find this link also on the website. If you visit our website, deminutesinternational.com, there you will also find the useful links that are there. And there, through that, you can also get subscription to that Ambo's website. So that you can do. I'll also put this link in this video, in the description of this video. The next question is from Harsha Reddy, writes, attempts for approbation only is 3 times. What if someone can't make through? Is that a dead end to the career? See, Harsha, in my previous, just now, I have made a video like few minutes back, and there I have mentioned that that is the dead end. If you do not clear the exam in 3 times, then that is the dead end. That one has to realize. If you don't make it, then there are other career other careers like pharma industry or clinical research or those things that you can do, but not as a practicing doctor. That is not possible at present. The next comment is from Trend Thamizan, and the topic here is a little different. He writes on the video which I have made about MBBS in Germany, that is for medical, for school students who wish to do medicine in Germany. He writes, I have tried and ended up as a failure and going to continue my passion in another EU country. Please don't only say the positives, also say about the negatives, because like you guys, most students are getting trapped and lose their dreams, and not all people who are coming to abroad like Germany are rich. Think before you say something. Trend Thamizan, thank you for the comment. Actually, I make these videos spontaneously, that is correct, but I don't say things without thinking. So like that, you should rely on that what I have said. I say fast, I don't make those very fancy videos, but things are well thought out. They are not without thinking, first of all, first point. Second point is that in none of the videos I have always maybe about MBBS or post-graduation, I have never said about things are easy or rosy or things are very like things you'll get on platter. It's not like that. There's always competition. There are exams. You have to prove yourself. You have to do interviews. And if somebody do not clear, then I mean, it's not the fault of the system. It is the fault of the person, his potential, his credentials. And that is one thing. That is point number two. Third point was, so people who are coming are not rich. See, when you think about going abroad to another country to study, one has to always think on the requirements, the potential that is required, the credit, the financial background that is required. If you think about going to say a country like, I don't know, Ukraine, I don't know how much it costs, but it costs, the lifestyle and living costs are certainly much less than that in Germany. So there are many people who go to Ukraine and in 10 lakh Indian rupees, they complete the entire MBBS. Like, I'm not sure about the value, if it's 10 lakh or 15 lakhs. But and the thought is that, okay, I will definitely not get into medical seat in India in a government medical college because I'm not that bright. First point. So the government medical college where the fees are negligible is out of question. Okay, that is a good point that they've understood that. Okay, let's not keep wasting time. Then about going to private medical college in India is going to cost a huge sum of money, and that I cannot, like my family cannot afford. So I mean, that is also out of question. So what do I do? I have to go abroad. Okay, where do I go? So if you think that time that you have to go to US or UK or Germany or Australia for a medical study, then you have to keep in mind that apart from the educational academic potential that is required for those countries, you also need financial background to live over there, to sustain over there. That one has to think. And then students think about Ukraine, China, Russia, and they go there. So yeah, there's a well thought out decision that candidates do. And the decision that you have taken about moving to another EU country, that you should have thought out before you tried and wasting your time about like doing medicine in Germany. Because I will mention once again here that medicine in Germany, I mean, I'm going off topic a little bit compared to our main course, that is of a PG in Germany. I'll just say one or two sentences more. See, people think, it is published through many consultancies that, okay, MBBS in Germany, medicine in Germany, very easy, you just have to learn the language. And it's not so, my dear friends, because in Germany, there are 50,000 candidates, approximately 50,000 candidates who want to study medicine. And out of that, only 10,000 get in. So there are 40,000 German candidates every year who do not get in. So it's not like the MBBS seats are lying vacant here. They're not getting, and they are then waiting. There are students in Germany's the note system, the mark system is different. So if you get less marks, they do not say that, okay, you never become a doctor. They will say you are in the Warte list, waiting list. And that waiting list can be 5 to 7 years long. That means in this 5 to 7 years, you will do something else. You will work as a nurse. You will work as a paramedic or something like that. You are not allowed to do studium. You cannot become an engineer or you cannot become an architect. That you are not allowed to, but you can do Ausbildung. You can work as a nurse, as I told you, Rettungsdienst. Those things you can do. You can work as a mechanic somewhere. Those things you can do for 5 to 7 years and wait till you get a medical position. This is about the native German student who gets less marks. So you can imagine if the native German students who is born here and has lived here and has German as his mother tongue, she finds this so difficult. How can foreign doctors or foreign students think that it will be a cakewalk, it will be very easy, and we'll just go learn the language for 1 year and we will become doctors in Germany? It's not so easy, my dear friends. So yeah, moving ahead, the next one is, what is PG? Procter & Gamble. Okay. Next is from Praveen Babu. Hi Deepak, I did DNB general surgery with 2 years post PG experience. I want to know how to get into fellowships in Germany. Please guide me. Praveen, I have made a video in my previous video. I have specifically made the title of that video is Fellowships in Germany. I would request you to go through that video. There you will find a clear-cut guideline like how and why. What fortile, the positives, the noctile, the negatives of PG fellowships in Germany, and yeah, these things. How about if I need, the next question is from Mirza Hakim. How about if I need training before this exam? Now he is asking about approbation exam. So how about if I need training? So if you need training, there are many coaching centers or coaching institutes who provide training regarding this approbation exam. If that is useful or not useful, required or not required, that is a different topic altogether. However, the coaching institutes are there which provide you. The next question is from Hardik Taylor. He writes, is there any way to register Indian MS Ortho degree in Germany? Sorry, Hardik, it is not doable. It is not possible to register MS Ortho degree in Germany. Here, if you come, what you can do at the most is you can send your documents for assessment, and if they like it, if they might reduce your duration of PG from 6 years to, let's say, maybe 5 years. That is also questionable. But otherwise, you have to start your PG again in Germany right from the beginning. Your benefit will be that since you will already have MS Ortho, you will have surgical skills, so you will be easily taken by the hospital, you will get jobs easily, but the bureaucratic pathway, that has to be the same. So the next question is from Arjun Kapoor. Writes, please make a video detailing the duration of various specialization courses offered in Germany after getting approbation. Is there a pathway to do super specialization courses after general surgery? The next question is also from him, and he writes about, he wants to, just a minute, yeah. Okay, he wanted super specialization, and the question is basically, is general surgery residency required before super specialization? See, Arjun, I will tell you the concept. I mean, this I understand. In India, we have 3 years general surgery, and only after that, somebody who wants to become a urologist, maybe a neurosurgeon, maybe a cardiothoracic surgeon, they can choose their path after general surgery. In Germany, it's not like that. In Germany, it's like the 6 years course that you have, you can choose right at the beginning. You can choose, if you want to become neurosurgeon, you can choose right at the beginning, at the first job, that okay, I want to do a assistant instructor in neurosurgery. And 6 years or 6 years you will do that neurosurgery, and then you will get your, then you can take the exam for neurosurgery. Same is cardiothoracic surgery, same is with bauch chirurgy, abdominal, the visceral surgery. So these things you can choose right at the beginning. You do not need to do, if you want to become a urologist, you do not have to do general surgery for that. Obviously there's a common trunk. So in all these branches that I have mentioned, first 2 years that you do, that is common. So even if you've done neurosurgery 2 years, that neurosurgery to, and you, now you want to move to say general surgery, as in the abdominal surgery, the visceral surgery, then those 2 years will be counted, and now you can choose a new hospital and new stella and go there. Or same that is with urology. If you have done say general surgery for 2 years and now you want to become a urologist, so then next 4 years you can do urology. So basically these super specialities, the urology, visceral chirurgy, neurochirurgy, cardiothoracic chirurgy, these are all 4 years courses, and the first 2 years are common trunk that you can do in any of the branches. So that is, it's irrelevant. Hope I answered your question. Next, the name is Johan. Thanks for the video. Can I apply for MSc in maybe anatomy without deficit Bescheid? See, Johan, you have to find out if there is a MSc course in anatomy. Because so far as I remember, anatomy is a medical branch, and for that, I mean, if you have MSc course, then you can very well apply for that, because that will be non-medical course, and for non-medical course, you do not require a deficit Bescheid. Non-medical as a non-clinical course, so you do not require a deficit Bescheid, and you can apply for MSc in say clinical research or MSc in molecular biology or molecular science, something like that. So if you apply to those branches, you do not need a deficit Bescheid. Okay, so next is Neha. She writes, hi sir, can we apply for hospitation in Germany without doing internship in India? As it will take one more, if a person has done MBBS from Ukraine and now wants directly to come to Germany without giving a... No, you cannot do that. Neha, you need to be a doctor to apply to Germany. Hospitation you can do. Okay. Yeah, I misread that somehow. Hospitation, even as a first year MBBS student, you can do hospitation. Okay, you can apply. What is hospitation? It's like a student. You apply for hospitation. You say that, okay, I want to stand there and look at what you guys are doing. And fine, if somebody finds it okay, let her come or let him come. Then you can go there and stay there for 2 weeks or 1 month and just watch what is going on at your own expense. And you can do that. Hospitation is possible at any level. Obviously, if you have language, if you have done B1 or B2, you will learn from that experience. If you have not done anything, you will not understand what is going on. However, you can do that, but it will not help you in any way. You can do that. You can come to Germany 1 month, stay there, and then go back again. It will not take your process any further because of the missing internship. So internship is required, because only after that internship you will get a license. You can take the exam in India, like MCI exam, and I think now it is dissolved. So, but the other equivalent exam, and then once you become a doctor, you get a registration in any of the countries, then you can apply to Germany. So the next question is from Anisul Kafar, right? Thank you for the great video. Is the waiting period same in every state? How long before the exam date can one get confirmation? Okay, he also writes, please give some more hints about AMBOS. Anisul also asks about the time difference is there. Like the waiting time is different in different states. So nobody can say for sure. In some states, you get about the termine, about the approbation exam, you are informed like 4 weeks before the exam. Or 2 weeks before the exam. So that in some places 2 months before the exam. So that is different in different states. And about AMBOS, I will mention the link in this description. Next is from Karan. Like UK PG is FRCS. What is name of degree in Germany? Is FAQ Arts. FAQ Arts is FAQ is a specialty and Arts is doctor. So specialist doctor. That is the name. Okay, so other questions, I have already commented on those questions, and I have concluded, like I have tried to answer them. And okay, with this I'll conclude this video. Thank you very much for watching, and please like this video if you like the contents, subscribe to the channel and spread the information across to your colleagues and to your friends. Because see, in my previous video I was talking about the Facebook forums and all, and it's very nice that people are sharing information. But the problem over there, what I find is that people are giving like tits and bits of information. And about the people who are answering, many times it is so that because I stay in touch with like many people write to me, and I know some names, some profiles, that okay, what they are, what are they doing, when did they come, what exam they have done or not done, or passed or not passed. So and when I see some things like people, they share information, that is a goodwill is there, that they want to give information, that is a very good thing. But the answers are tits bits, like you do not know the entire perspective is not there, only a particular one line answer or only small details are there. Many times I find it more confusing, it creates more confusion for the candidates, because now initially the candidate did not know about this part, now he has heard this thing but has not understood it, now does not, so instead of clearing things he is now confused. So goodwill is there, people are sharing information, that's a very good thing. But and people who are watching this video, if you guys are writing, please write elaborate descriptions, because then the people who are trying to help are actually benefited. And if you write just small sentences or some copy paste from some places, so it creates more confusion. If you just share links, it creates more confusion and people do not understand. So I request guys to put more elaborate content, more elaborate information, and also give your credentials, that who you are and what you have done. So that the question, the explanation is somehow trustworthy, and not that somebody is trying to kill competition, that is by giving like spreading some vague information, vague ideas, so that people who are on the path will get distracted and that will create less competition. Because I have come across people who with that mindset as well. That is a typical competitive mindset that we have, that we are actually grown up with, we in our school, in our medical colleges, that okay, to keep yourself ahead, you spread like vague things, so that people who are watching you and are reading you will get somehow distracted. So there are people with that mindset. I would request those people not to do that, and people who take information from different sources to be more vigilant and more cautious before implementing the information. Alright then, thank you very much, have a nice day, and wish you all the best for your future. I'll come back soon with a new video with more information. Thank you guys, bye bye.